Just give me a little bit of peace. Steady job and some food to eat. Just give me a little bit of peace. Steady job and some food to eat.
I was watching an old news story from Minnesota from the 80s, you know, just in preparation of the interview. And and they mentioned the Blue Disciples. This was is it safe to say then that the GDs and the Crips had that eight ball alliance thing at the beginning?
No, we never knew nothing about none of that. Like, we separate, like, a lot of people was thinking that GDs and Crips was just like the same or none of that, but we're different. You know, we don't rock no stars. You know, you from LA, we ain't rocking no stars. No Crips is not rocking no stars and nothing like that. You know what I'm saying? But we still get along with them, though. You know, we like shit. It is what it is. Mm-hmm.
Well, shit, to the best of your knowledge, when did Crips and Bloods first make an appearance in Minneapolis?
In Minnesota?
Yeah.
I'd say the Bloods was here, like, in the early 80s or the late 80s.
Okay.
And the Crips came around. I know from my hood, when my homie Big Chat came down here, you know, he came down here. So I'd say that was, like, in the early 80s too, around that time. But he was on the low. He was getting a lot of money, you know. So he was getting a lot of money. So he started flipping people. Come here, go half a chicken to flip this, or here goes some money. You know, so motherfuckers was doing it because how many people has ever seen a half a bird or had a whole bird to themselves? So when a person coming giving you that to make you get down, I mean, people was doing it. They was doing it. But once they got on, it was really what it was. You know, we're not doing no faking, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Yeah, from what I understand, Minneapolis was there kind of at the, you know, the early stages of the expansion, excuse me, from L.A. to across the country of the Crips and the Bloods. I know, you know, crack cocaine obviously had a lot to do with that, but in your opinion, did movies like Colors and, you know what I'm saying, gangster rap, did they have any, you know, big effect on gangs, you know, from the West Coast?
Yeah, they had. Colors had a big influence on us, you know. And if a person say that, it wasn't their line, because when that movie came out, and like, you got to figure, we from a place where we wasn't really knowing nothing about it. So when we found out and seen the movie, like, okay, and that's what it is. And you know, a lot of people took it from there and went with it. But what really, really got us really going was when people started coming up here from LA. See, people was coming up here from LA way back in the days, but we wasn't really knowing it. They wasn't really saying, like, I know a lot of Crips that was coming from L.A. that don't even say cuz, really. You would never even know. We got some older homies down there in Gardena that had come up here, and you won't even know that they Crips. They never say cuz, but they got so much money. So when they was coming up here getting money back in the day, because our state is known for getting a lot of money, you know what I'm saying? So when they came up here and started getting a lot of money, then that's when the people start flipping from being Chicago gang to being Crips, and people that wasn't in gangs started to be Crips and Bloods, because we seen how the activeness was when we was watching the movie, you know, and that's what it was. We really got on like that.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Now let's, you mentioned Gardena. Let's talk about Shotgun specifically.
Yeah.
To the best of your knowledge, before we jump into, you know, Minneapolis, Shotgun, tell everybody kind of a history, you know, of how Shotgun got started out here in Gardena, right?
Yeah, I don't really know the beginning of the history, because I wasn't, you know what I'm saying? A lot of people, if you're not from the land, you really ain't going to know the very, very beginning. I just know what the homies that came up here.
Share to the best of your knowledge.
Like the homie Smiley, you know what I'm saying? The homie Mad Bill. Mad Bill was from the Nine, you know what I'm saying? So they was coming up here teaching us the game. They was telling us about paybacks, and you know, it was a lot of Crips that we was never even hearing about. Like, damn, okay, that's cool. But what they was really pushing was to get that money. You know what I'm saying? So that's why our hood always had money. It's just what it is. Like, we kind of like spoiled, because our homies always stayed in touch with the homies in the land. You know, a lot of people claim Crip and Blood up here. They don't even be having no ties to their homies down there in the land. But we was just fortunate enough to have that. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
But now our whole city, the whole north side, you know, the whole north side, a lot of the, all the young cats on the north side of Minneapolis is repping Shotgun and Crip. You know, right now our shit is split up in cliques now. So niggas is banging against each other, inside hood banging, because we're clique banging now. you know, we're all from the hood, but niggas start breaking off with certain sets. Like I was looking at a thing on Vlad TV, mm-hmm. and he was showing the Grape Streets, and they had like, it was like a gang of Grape Streets, but they say they hood is so deep that they was broke off in sections.
Yeah.
And I'm like, okay, that's basically how we was doing down. That's how we're doing down here. We're just click banging now. Mm-hmm. And it's getting crazy because we're killing each other. We're killing our own homies, and it's just stupid to me.
Let's take it back then. I know you said you were seeing your pops, you know, do his thing when he was Crippin'. Was he shotgun also, or was he something else?
No, my dad was a Raymond.
Okay.
Yeah, he was a Raymond Crip.
Gotcha.
And he had went down there and bumped into some of the Raymonds down there, then came back up here with the homie Big O. Big O from the land down there. He came up here with the homie Big O, and they put the Raymonds on down here, down on 14th in Chicago. That's on the south side, you know what I'm saying? Right kind of by our hospital. But when they put them on, and so I was seeing a lot of that. I grew up in Raymond Hood, you know, so I was seeing a lot of that. And then, because a lot of people thought I was going to be a Raymond. But I just happened to got down with the homies from the gun, and I went from there.
As the time goes by and the earth rotates, we gon' fly high up to outer space. And we would never fall down. I'm one with the universe, call me the Sam. The bass booming in your speaker with the microphone I possess, it's a heater. You better drop it, let go. You can't touch my beats or my flow, nigga. Kevin Smith, my name, but not the director, we ain't the same, man. I'm a pimp by nature, inside of me is a God, the creator. Pursuing my dreams, cause anything is possible, you know what I mean. I wanna live comfortable, but gotta be clean. But working every day from 9 to 5 in my thing.
I feel like I'm trapped, can't get out of the bubble. I'm running out of time, overload, I'm in trouble. I feel like I'm trapped, can't get out of the bubble. I'm running out of time, overload, I'm in trouble.
One by one, we start to subtract them. Separate facade from who really bought that action. Feel like I'm trapped in the room without a key. Four walls surrounding me, stripping my identity. Got me in the bubble to observe and deceive. Take away my culture and my nationality. Talking about double jeopardy and double standard to killing my folks. Like it don't even matter. And when we gather, disgusted by the charades, bullets spray the crowd, target practicing the game. No accountability, so who bears the blame? They want to see us violent to justify the change.